as I explain about Pythagoras theorem, so here we can take an example to understand that. You are seeing a right angle triangle on your screen, in which one you can see that perpendicular, that is your 6, base, that is your 8, and they are asking about hypotenuse, okay? So regarding to Pythagoras theorem, you can see that you can write there hypotenuse square, that is perpendicular square plus base square, okay?
Oh,
that
okay.
Means in that condition 6 square, that will be 36, okay? 8 square, that will be 64. If you will add 36 and 64, okay, you will get 100. You have to find the square root of 100.
Is that 10?
Yep, that will be 10. And if you will mark it, perfect. Pardon? What is the area of the smallest square? Oh, sorry. I told you the answer. I told you the answer, but they are only asking there, what is the area of smallest square? So smallest square, that will be 36, okay?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's right. Area of smallest square, that will be 36, okay? And then what will be the area of next smallest square? You can see that side is 8. So it will be 8 are 64, okay?
Okay.
Now it will be 64. Perfect. That's right. So as usual, I explained that to you regarding to Pythagoras, the area of hypotenuse square, that will be the sum of area of smallest two squares. Okay. So that means you have to add these two. Okay. So 36 plus 64, you will get 100. Yep, that's right. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So largest square, there will be 100. Now you have to find a square root, because that you have to find side there. Okay. So it will be 10. And that's your answer. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Or you can also understand that in this way, because that you can apply formula that x square, that is 6 square plus 8 square, okay?
Okay.
So x square, that will be 36 plus 64, okay? You have to add 36 plus 64, and then you will get x square equals to 100, and then x equals to square root of 100, that will be 10, okay?
10, yes.
So it is the best way to understand the missing side, okay, which you want to find out. Clear?
Oh, okay, yes.